Please see the link in the description to download a worksheet for this video. Experiments can be dangerous. If you are a child, never do experiments unless your parent, guardian, or adult educator says it's all right and is there with you the whole time. This video builds on concepts presented in other videos. If you haven't already seen them, we suggest you view them before watching this video. This man's surfboard is stationary because it has no motion energy. In physics, we use the term kinetic energy to refer to motion energy. When a surfer is riding a breaking wave, then the wave gives kinetic energy to the surfboard. This common example illustrates that waves carry energy, and that they can transfer that energy to objects or people. In this video, we'll learn about wave energy, including examples of kinetic energy transferring out of and into waves, examples of energy being converted from waves and being converted into waves, transportation of energy by waves versus transportation of matter by waves, the effect of amplitude on the energy of mechanical waves, and the effect of frequency on the energy of electromagnetic waves. We'll start by giving examples of kinetic energy transferring out of and into waves. Even when we're not surfing, we get kinetic energy from every wave that lifts us. A single ocean wave can carry so much energy that it can easily lift a ship weighing thousands of pounds. Every time a wave moves something, that wave is giving some of its kinetic energy to that body or object. That means kinetic energy is transferring out of the waves. When we jump from a high place, we get a lot of kinetic energy. When we hit the water, we transfer all of that kinetic energy to the water. The water then transfers almost all of that kinetic energy into waves. These waves are carrying the kinetic energy that this person once had. The most common way that ocean and lakes get waves is from the wind. Like water, the air is made of many tiny particles we call molecules. As air molecules collide with water molecules, the air molecules transfer some of their kinetic energy to the water molecules, and this then creates waves. The faster the wind is, the bigger the waves become. Likewise, for membrane waves, such as in flags, their kinetic energy is coming from the wind. String waves get their kinetic energy from somebody or something moving them. Acoustic waves, such as sound waves in the air, are also due to the motion of tiny molecules. The motion of those molecules is kinetic energy, and that kinetic energy came from the motion of something else hitting those molecules, just like this speaker's diaphragm is hitting grains of sand to give them kinetic energy. Next, we'll give examples of energy being converted from waves and being converted into waves. The wave stops propagating in this spring when its kinetic energy has been converted into heat energy. When an object changes shape, such as when waves travel through it, this creates some heat. Here's an example using blue tack. After just a few seconds of quickly changing its shape, the tack is hotter than this man's hands. Microwave ovens convert the energy in electromagnetic waves into heat energy as they warm our food. And that microwave oven converted electrical energy, what we commonly call electricity, into electromagnetic waves that then carried that energy. Even our simple devices, such as a flashlight, are doing energy conversions. In this case, electrical energy is being converted into an electromagnetic wave we commonly call light. Next, we'll discuss transportation of energy by waves versus the transportation of matter by waves. This pond has small waves that are propagating towards the north at a speed of 1 foot every second. If we put a leaf on this pond, how far north will this leaf go in 2 seconds? The leaf barely moves north. This surprises some people, especially given what we've seen with breaking waves near the shore. Here's a wave on a string. If you focus on just one green bead, you'll notice that although the wave is propagating towards the right, the bead only goes up and down. We see this same thing when transverse waves travel through a flag. The waves propagate away from the flagpole, but the flag never leaves the pole. Here's an animation of molecules in the air as sound waves travel through them as longitudinal waves. We can see the compression followed by an area of rarefaction. But if you focus on just the red molecules in this broader animation, you'll see that each one is only oscillating a short distance back and forth, and none of the molecules are being transported with the wave. Because of these observations, introductory courses usually state that waves transport energy, but do not transport matter. The word transport means to move something from one place to another place. But this may be different than your observations at the beach. Every wave that reaches this shore washes onto the land. Then that water flows back into the ocean. So each wave does transport matter, albeit only a short distance. Water waves are a major exception to the general observation that waves do not transport matter. For example, this is driftwood, which has been transported to the shore by ocean waves. In the prior video, we showed this model but noted that it was an oversimplification of how particles move in water waves. This is a more accurate model. Each red particle traces a blue path as it moves. These particles are transported in the direction of wave propagation. This is called Stokes drift. Perhaps the most dramatic example of water waves transporting matter is when a breaking wave hits an obstacle, such as a wall. The matter, in this case water molecules, temporarily leave the ocean until they flow back in. But with the exception of breaking waves, water waves transport matter at a very slow speed compared with the speed of wave propagation. That's why this leaf appears to be hardly moving north. Even large waves pass right through people and hardly move them towards the shore. To catch a wave, a surfer must paddle very fast or the wave will go right past that surfer and hardly transport the surfer at all. A surfer can only stay on the front face of a breaking wave if she or he has a lot of skill and makes some effort. All electromagnetic waves follow the simple rule that they transport energy and not matter. Next, we'll discuss the effect of amplitude on the energy of mechanical waves. These waves have an amplitude of about 3 feet. That means their crests are 3 feet above the equilibrium level of the water. Waves with an amplitude of 3 feet that are about 1 mile wide have an amount of energy equal to 1 gallon of gasoline. This wave has an amplitude of 15 feet. If it was 1 mile wide, how much energy, in gallons of gasoline, would it have? This wave's energy would equal 25 gallons of gasoline. Although the amplitude went up by a factor of 5, the energy went up by a factor of 25. That's because a wave's amplitude has a major effect on the energy in a mechanical wave. Likewise, amplitude plays a major role in the energy of string waves. For example, the waves on the bottom string have an amplitude that is 3 times greater than those in the top string. Yet the energy per wave in the bottom string is 9 times greater than the energy per wave in the top string. Likewise, when we turn up the volume on our speakers, each sound wave gets a larger amplitude. And that larger amplitude means each wave has much more energy. Our final topic is to discuss the effect of a wave's frequency on the energy of an electromagnetic wave. On this diagram of the electromagnetic spectrum, as we move from the left to the right, the amount of energy per wave increases. That's because the frequency per wave increases. The 3 highest classes of energy are ultraviolet, X-rays, and gamma rays. These 3 classes can cause ionizing radiation, which means they can burn us and cause cancer. That's why we wear sunblock to protect ourselves against ultraviolet rays from the sun. It's why we wear lead aprons to protect ourselves from X-rays. And it's why we stay away from products or areas that may be generating gamma rays. This trend of energy increasing with a wave's frequency also applies to the colors of light. For example, since violet light is on the right in this diagram, that means it has more energy than red light. And that also means that every wave of blue light has more energy than every wave of green light. This difference in energy in colors of light may explain some plant biology. If we look at a leaf with a microscope, we can see these green spheres called chloroplasts. They contain the chemical called chlorophyll, which is capturing the energy in light to drive photosynthesis. Chlorophyll is excellent at absorbing blue light, but it reflects green light. This is the reason why almost all healthy plants are green. We are seeing the green light they're reflecting and are not seeing the higher energy blue light they're absorbing. Here's a summary of this video, plus some additional information. Please pause the video if you wish to read this. Please subscribe if you'd like to be notified of future educational videos we make. Thanks for your attention.